And some of her concerns really touched my heart because I've been there. And when she talks about the struggle and having the struggle over and over for years and then feeling healed and going back into the struggle again, when she talked about feeling alone and not having anyone understand her, when she talked about being a Christian and wondering, is this a spiritual battle? And kind of wondering where God is in this, and is there potential for full healing, or will I be this way for the rest of my life? Some of these comments that were said by this stranger, I'm not going to mention her name, I'll protect her privacy, I'd like to respond to. And so I'm doing this video really for her, but I thought, why not? I'll share it online and see if it helps anybody else. I struggled with depression and anxiety for several years. I'd like to say I'm healed, but let's be clear about that. I'm currently still on my antidepressant. I tried going off of it for a while and it didn't go well. I'm back on a low dose of that. I also maintain Plexus for good gut health. Please read more about that if you haven't. It's basically a probiotic and some things to stabilize sugars. I also continue with progesterone cream, which I highly recommend in the 40s because hormones can be. So with those additions in my life, yes, I am free from depression. And most days I'm free from anxiety. It does not interfere with my life at this point. So, so glad. But there's some things, if you have not seen or read my articles, please go back to my blog, read my articles on depression and anxiety, because that's kind of, you need to know that before you understand what I'm gonna be saying in the video. Also, I put a video together talking about gut health. I did mention going off my antidepressants, but as I've said, I've decided to go back on them. But feel free to get some recommendations of what worked for me through that video, through my blog. It's acoffeewithfriends.com. Go on there and read about the depression and anxiety. After that, let's talk some more because I've got some more ways that I was able to overcome anxiety and depression. And I say overcome basically to wait it out until it healed and to allow my body to be in the best condition to be healed.
The reason I say that is as a teaching in a book that
I really love by Claire Weeks, Hope and Healing, Hope and Help for Your Nerves is the name of the book. This book
was read many times during my struggle.
But one thing she mentions is depression is like any other illness. It comes and it will go. But we can set our bodies up right to be healed. And that's what I looked at doing is how can I get my body set up right to get over this depression, anxiety, and get beyond at least the peak of it, the heat of it. I'm not making sense. Sorry about that. But let me let you know what I do now, what I did to overcome. One is I went on Lexapro. I'm not going to talk a lot about antidepressants. Some work for some work for others. I waited 2 years of my depression before I went on an antidepressant, only because of the stigma.
Ridiculous, because just the 10 milligrams of Lexapro really
helps me a lot. I also went to see a doctor who does a lot of herbal medicines, looks a lot at hormones. He's more thorough than a normal family practice doctor. He helped me by looking at my progesterone levels. He did a spit test
that was really accurate,
talking about how I was really high in progesterone, or estrogen, I'm sorry, and that led to my anxiety issues. I now use a progesterone cream, and that has really helped keep my hormones at level. Really like that. Another thing that really helped me, like I said, I want to say it one more time, is there's a book that I use constantly, and it's called Hope and Help for Your Nerves. It is by Claire Weeks. I highly recommend getting this book, highlighting, putting some of those truths into you. I love that book. It helped me with my anxiety. It has a chapter on depression that was very helpful. I highly recommend getting that book. One of the things that Claire Weeks mentioned that was very important to me was she emphasized the fact you have to be sleeping. And if you need
medication to help with that, you need to be
taking that medication. Sleep is vital to get over anxiety and depression. It is not optional. Without sleep, I really noticed it. In the weeks I went without sleep, I thought I was going crazy. I was losing my mind. When I finally took her advice, got on a good sleep medication with the help of a physician, I got on Ambien, on a low dose of Ambien, and took that to sleep at night.
Finally rest. So get
sleep and get the medication
that you need to get to sleep, because you can't heal from depression and anxiety without good sleep. Before the
Ambien and before an antidepressant, I was going through panic attacks that would last all night long. It was miserable. So
sleep. Another thing is positivity.
I'm a strong believer. I now serve, I'm living in Asia, and I serve God here. And so what I can tell you is my walk with God was like this before all this happened, and it is now. But I really had a hard time dealing with the fact that I was dealing with anxiety, depression, panic attacks, while I had a good relationship with God. It just shocked me that I would be going through that. I dealt with a lot of guilt because of that. I dealt with a lot of kind of misbeliefs and stigma. The church was not, like I said, like I think, just really receptive to me. They didn't have a lot of good sound advice. That's why a lot of the advice I'm giving you is from the secular world.
One of the websites that
one of the websites that helped me the most is called Tiny Buddha.
And I'm going to say that to you
because it breaks my heart that the Christian world didn't have better positive, encouraging things to say
to me. It dealt a lot with,
well, are you sure God's just pruning you?
Or maybe there's sin you haven't dealt with, when that actually wasn't the
issue. The issue was
I was dealing with some chemical, emotional
issues that needed chemical,
emotional answers, you know? And
tinybuddha.com did do that. I hate saying that.
But another thing is
positive reinforcement.
I began listening to some albums that had
it was positive self-talk, affirmations.
These affirmations were so important to me. One of the albums I listened
to is by Amy Applebaum. I'm going to be including this in the comments. Amy Applebaum. She has an album called Be Anxiety Free. In that, she has daily affirmations for change and actions for change. These affirmations, I had to put positive truths back into me because my brain was saying negative things to me. I was feeling horrible.
It was lies. These positive affirmations helped. Another
author is Carmen Warrington. She had an album she has one that helps us sleep. It's called Rest Well, Sleep Well album. A lot of positive things going in while you're trying
to sleep at night. She has
an album called Positive Self-Talk, one called Acceptance. So Carmen Warrington had quite a few different kinds of albums you can find. I found it on iTunes. That really helped me, get
through that. This positive self-talk
I listened to in the morning, noon, and night. I really needed it. Everything positive. I found myself only staying with positive people, negative people, people who were
critical, negative.
I had to stay far away from. Movies, shows that had any kind of something sad or negative, I was very sensitive to. I kept everything positive for a period of time. And even reading the Bible, I chose the most encouraging verses to read for a period of time because I'm guilt-ridden. So it took me a while to get back into the whole Bible, but I stayed out of Job and I kept with the positive things for a period of time. I did mantras such as God will heal me, this is temporary.
I chose the perspective on
my depression, anxiety. I chose to look at it as it's temporary, period.
I like
the old description called nervous breakdown,
where you basically look at this as a period of time in my life and it will end.
And I said that to myself and I believed it for long periods of time. I chose to believe that.
One of the last things I want to
mention is gut health. Please read more about gut health and its relationship to anxiety and depression. It is key.
Your
natural microbiome in your stomach has a lot to do with your health, physically, emotionally.
We found that
serotonin is made
actually initiated in the stomach and has a lot to do with your microbiome.
So read more about that. I've chosen to use what I think is the best. Plexus. Plexus has a probiotic out there called Vital Biome. It is a probiotic specifically for people who have struggled with anxiety and depression. I take that every day and I see a huge difference on that. I've also chosen to take the Plexus Slim because it keeps your sugars
balanced all day long so you don't
do these high up and down. If you may notice,
times of depression may come at times when you're exhausted. So the Plexus Slim helps kind of keep me balanced. So that's also something that I've used. So read more about gut health.
So I just kind of want to share some of these things that's helped me through anxiety and depression. I'm so happy to be
what I can sit on the other side
of it. If you ask me, do I have struggles, lifelong struggles with anxiety and depression? I would say yes.
But I would say now for
a couple of years, I'm able to
live free without it interfering with my life.
I know what I need and I continue to take that and I don't have any plans going off of it at this point.
But
I want to say that anyone who's watching this video, I do pray for you,
especially my friend who decided to send me an email through my website. You can also send me an email if you'd like to talk specifically or if you have questions. I would love to address it. I would love to walk anybody out of being
stuck in depression and anxiety. So please do
look up the books that I share, the CDs that I've shared, positive affirmations,
and you will come
through this. Thank you. Bye-bye.